Welcome to Frida's Garden. And Seismic's checking out the tomatoes. And that's what I would like to talk about today. Tomatoes. I want to show you my once beautiful... Look at them. Says I gotta check them out. Those are weird tomatoes. The once beautiful tomatoes that were... That I put in this garden that has compost only from my own compost bin, mixed with dirt, mixed with the soil, of course. But I really put it full of compost in here. Anyway, and it sat for about a year without anything being planted in it. And these are all volunteer tomatoes, and they were doing so good. And then there was this terrible heat, like 95 degrees, and they kind of withered back. But then they came back again. And much to my dismay, I mean, they started growing pretty good, so I thought this is gonna be good. But look at these tomatoes. Now, I must say Epsom salts to prevent blossom end rot, and I don't seem to have it. But what is with these tomatoes? I'm not too sure if I ordered too much or not enough. I know this, hey, get out of there. Seismic. No, he's just eating a little bit of that. These are the mustard seed that went to little tiny seeds. I don't know. This is not what I call great tomatoing. What is that? Pathetic things. So is this like tomato blight, or is it from the sun? Because this only gets like sun right now. It's about, I think it's about 12:30, 1 o'clock. And in another hour, there won't be any sun here. So it gets morning sun. I don't know. But look at that one. That one looks happy. But if we look down the plant, starts dying off at the bottom, which I know is expected, but it just doesn't seem right. So I don't know what I'm doing wrong. The top of the plant looks good. So I don't know what's going on. All right, let's go take a look at another tomato. See if I can... Okay, here we are in my swing garden with lima beans and my cool Big Mama lima beans. Let's take a look at these tomatoes. This is not a volunteer tomato. And it seems to be doing pretty healthy in here. And this is compost mixed in with Miracle-Gro. This is a sun sugar that I bought, and it seems to be doing pretty good. Sometimes I'll leave the hose, you know, because it's leaking like a drop every once in a while. And instead of shutting the hose off, I'll just leave it here. It seems to be doing pretty good. Ouch. Hit my head on that thing. All right, let's take a look at another tomato. San Marzano. These are the San Marzano heirloom tomatoes that I paid $3.68 for each one. But I think they were more than one in a thing. Now they're doing fine. It's hot today. It's like, it's been in the 85s, 87s. And yesterday was, I think it was 82. San Marzanos are doing really good. And I've been really conscious about coming out here and watering more than I have in the past. It's a fine line between watering too much and not enough. And I know I should fix my whole drip system, but it's later. And these zucchini's doing pretty good. Now it's going to be noon, and they kind of flop down. But then they come back. And then there are these poor babies. And these are the sun sugars and the black cherries. And they seem to have come back now. They were having a problem because I planted them on like a really hot day. But I see they're starting to perk up. So let's just hope that that works out. Let's look at some other. Now here we have my bumblebees. And I think I only have one bumblebee. And I think that's a bumblebee. But these are seeds that are given to me by Kayla, which I love you, Kayla. And look, there's more over here. And They look like they're doing pretty good. These are indigo rose, I believe. Yes, indigo rose. I thought these were all bumblebees. They seem to be doing good. Now these over on this side are not doing as good as this side. And if you even go over here farther, these indigo roses are not doing good. And I used to attribute that to this wall, but look how far the sun is. I mean, the sun is way up there, so I can't blame the bougainvillea, which isn't there anymore. And let's see, these are just small, but they all seem to be perky and reach into the sky. This one fell over because it was a bad, you know, it didn't do very good. Oh, there we go. Kind of got it wrapped around there. I do, sometimes I get all into staking and sometimes I just go for whatever happens. Like this, for instance. These aren't doing too good, but you know, if it works, it works. And I can just go grab a stick out of a tree and fix it or put it on the side. The San Marzano are determinate, and I think they're doing, they're going to be strong. This one does good compared to, get that weed out of there. That's a San Marzano compared to the ones over on here, which have been, they've all been growing the same time that they have been growing. All right, let's take a look at another tomato. Now here we have a heat tolerant tomato. I have two of them, and it's called, it's a determinate Florida 91, and it's supposed to be heat resistant. So Florida, he seemed to be coming through because it really does look heat resistant, that's for sure. And it's nothing's happening to it. Nothing on the bottom of the leaves to make me worried. No spider mites. I don't see anything. You're happy. You're happy, aren't ya? Let's shake your hand. They like human contact. Okay, let's take a look at it. Now here's an indigo rose that I planted the same time I planted the other ones. I took out this one. I've been told there's spider mites on here, but I got my magnifying glass. I swear I cannot see them. I always have lots of spiders, but I couldn't find any spider mites, and I guess I need better glasses or something. Do you see any? It just seems so pathetic when they grow here. Don't know why. But, of course, I didn't plant them with sugar or anything. So those are those two. And then the same plant is right here. And this is a, oh, excuse me, indigo rose, which seems to be doing very good right now. And I mean, at least it's got some nice blossoms on it. Aren't they pretty? Pretty blossoms. And it seems to have caught a hold here. Let's see if it's got spider mites. No, you know, Pat. Ouch, what the hell just bit me? Get off me. Sorry, that was a fly. I can't believe that fly just bit me. That hurt. Okay, I'm gonna go in now. See ya.